Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and good afternoon. So let's start our lecture with the Ummul Kitab Al-Fatihah. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alhamdulillahirrabbilalamin. Ar-Rahmanirrahim. Maliki yawmiddin. Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in. Ihdinas siratal mustaqim. Siratal ladzina an'amta 'alaihim ghairil maghdubi 'alaihim waladdallin. Amin. Hello guys. So for today we are going to continue module number 4, ACL concept, which cover on standard access list and also extended access list. So there are four objectives for this chapter. So first, it's about how we can explain how ACL filter the traffic. Second concept of wildcard mask. So this already be learned during your Cisco 2 last semester. Wildcard mask, so which is can be said as an inverse from the subnet mask. So we have the method how to calculate the wildcard mask. And the third objective is to create ACLs, how we can create the ACL. So this we just cover on the theory concept. So you need to know how to create the ACLs before we do the configurations. And then the last is we will do the comparisons between the standard and extended ACLs. So the purpose of ACL, as we know that ACL will use a sequential list. Sequential list means that there are the sequence number. Okay, they flow one by one from one line to another line. So let's say you create the first ACL statement. Number one, you have a statement kat sini. Number two, line number two, you will have your statement. And also you have the third statement. Sequential ni maksudnya dia akan check satu per satu statement secara sequence. Daripada first statement, apa yang kita buat, second statement and third statement. Dia takkan pergi kepada third dulu ataupun second dulu untuk buat filter tanpa melalui one. So maksudnya kat sini sequence mesti melalui satu per satu. Alright. So either you permit or you deny statement lah. So ini yang kita panggil sebagai packet filtering. So packet filtering will do either you permit or you deny the statement. Dua tu je, you permit or you deny. Okay, so we call this statement, this line as ACE, access control entries, ataupun we also call as ACL statement. So just a name. So bila kita sebut tentang ACE, line tu lah you punya statement. Okay, which is access control entries or ACL statement. Kita buat statement ataupun you buat entries, still the same things. Okay, next is about why we need to implement ACLs. Okay, for example, we can use the ACLs to increase the network performance. Sebab apa? Dia boleh increase the network performance sebab kita boleh choose which type of traffic yang kita nak control, nak limit. Okay, tak semua traffic yang kita gunakan kan, ataupun certain group of people, kita nak give the access to the that kind of group. So kita boleh limit lah group A, for example, staff will get the all access, and then the students kita akan limitkan access. Sebab apa? Sebab network kita bandwidth tak banyak. So we need to manage our networks and bandwidth. So of course, one of the method we can use limitations of network traffic based on the group of people. So tujuan adalah untuk kita do the increase, untuk kita increasekan network performance. Tapi kalau network kita bandwidth besar, mungkin kita tak buat lah limit. Alright. Also, we also can control traffic flow. Okay, improve the basic level of security. So paling kurang kita boleh tingkatkan security. Contohnya kita nak block telnet sessions, kita nak block SSH sessions, okay, ataupun daripada satu VLAN kepada satu VLAN. Contohnya VLAN finance kan, VLAN finance kan memang dia punya critical part. For example, this group of people finance, dia ada information, critical information. So you nak block ataupun you nak control access to this group of people finance. Orang lain tak boleh access. So kat situ ataupun hanya certain group of people saja yang boleh access to each other. So kita boleh buat dan juga tingkatkanlah level of security. And then filter traffic based on the traffic type. So kalau kita nak benarkan traffic untuk keluar masuk melalui router tadi, semua traffic ataupun certain type of traffic, so we can filter by using the ACLs. Okay. And then and so on. Alright, so the next is about the packet filterings. As I mentioned that packet filterings occurs at layer 3 and layer 4. So layer 3 adalah networks, layer 4 is transport. So very clear dekat sini eh. So kalau kita implement ACL ada dua lah. Yang pertama kita ada standard ACL. Second we have extended ACL. So apa beza antara standard dengan extended? Yang ni you all kena ingat lah. Kalau standard ACL, dia hanya filter using the source IPv4 address ataupun IPv6, which is ACLs, standard ACLs filter based on the source address. Okay, extended dia boleh jadi source and destination address. So kalau you nak filter daripada satu source ataupun satu destination, dia boleh. You need to use extended. Ataupun you nak do the packet filterings based on types of traffic. Contoh TCP, UDP. Okay, dua benda ni you kena pakai extended ACL. Or you want to filter based on port number services. So you need to use extended ACL. So kalau you tengok dekat sini, kenapa dia cakap standard ACLs works at layer 3 only. Sebab layer 3 adalah layer network eh. So dia hanya melibatkan IP address. So kalau lebih daripada situ, kalau kita nak pakai extended, of course dia akan pergi kepada layer 4, which is dia lebih tinggi lah, melibatkan transport, TCP, connections, UDP, ports number and so on. It's not just about the IP address anymore. Okay, so ada dua beza kat situ lah. Standard hanya melibatkan source address. Okay, extended melibatkan source, destinations, port number, services, type of traffics. Okay, so next is about ACL operations. So dekat sini we have a router, okay, and then we have the interface, which is we call as inbound interface and outbound interface. In other words, simple, inbound incoming traffic, traffic yang nak masuk ke dalam router. Outbound outgoing traffic, traffic yang keluar daripada router. So kita nak implement access list, kita kena tahu dekat interface mana yang kita nak configure, either sebelah sini ataupun sebelah sinilah. So senang cakap, interface yang masuk to the router, entering the router, we call as inbound ACL ataupun incoming ACLs. The traffic that you want to filter on here is outbound ACLs or outgoing ACLs. Okay, masuk, is it interface? Kalau incoming interface, inbound, exiting the interface, outbound interface. Alright. Okay. One more important notes that you need to know. Bila kita bercakap tentang ACL, alright, ACL. Tadi saya cakap kita ada entries kan? Kita ada entries, alright. So we have the entries or statement. So inilah ACE ni. Setiap entry tu kita ada. And then last kali kita kena ingat entry yang kita masukkan tadi. Let's say we have 4 lines. 1, 2, 3, 4. So yang kita tak nampak dekat last kali, we call as implicit deny. Which is dekat sini dia akan deny all. Yang ni kita tak nampak eh. Kita tak nampak dalam statement. Tapi dia akan tutup the entries by having the implicit deny statement. So last kali statement adalah deny all. Yang tu kita tak nampak. Alright. Okay, next. Wildcard. So yang ni we already cover on CCNA2. So saya just buat summarization sahaja. Wildcard mask, how to calculate the wildcard mask, very simple. Okay, shortcut method, kita tahu semua satu, semua binary one adalah 255, 255, 255, 255, right? So this will be your main. Alright, so let's say you want to assume first example, let's say you want to assume this network 3.0/24. So kita kena tahu /24 subnet dia adalah 255.255.255.0. So wildcard, you ambil 255.255.255.255. Yang ni, you tolak yang ni, you akan dapatlah jawapan dia. Ha ni, 0.0.0.0.255. Simple. Boleh eh? Saya harap you all faham. Okay, next, let's say this IP 192.168.3.32/28. So we need to find the subnet mask. So /28 subnet mask is 240, means that we have 14 users based on this address. So apa kita nak buat? Nak calculate wildcard mask, you ambil this value, all binary ones, you minus with this subnet mask, then you will get this wildcard mask. So this is the simplest way or the shortcut method to determine the wildcard mask. So next example, okay, let's say we have two networks, 10.0, 11.0. So these two network, we can do a summarization, which is we combine these two network and we summarize, it will lead to this new network, new summarized network 192.168.10.0/23. Same thing, /23. Calculate the subnet mask, so you will get 255.255.255.0. So you take all binary ones value minus with this subnet mask, then you will get this wildcard mask 0.0.1.255. So you can use this wildcard mask implement inside these entries. For example, dekat bahagian sini lah, access list 10 permit source address wildcard mask. So kat sini adalah wildcard mask. Kita tak pakai subnet mask, right? Dalam case example ni. Okay, for the wildcard mask, you need to remember if you want to use a single host, single IP, you need to use a wildcard 0.0.0.0. So kalau you pakai this wildcard 0.0.0, it will lead to the single host. Okay. If you want to apply your statement to any networks, okay, which is mana-mana pun, semua, okay, you can use any, which is it will use all available networks. Any lah, kalau you tengok 255 ni, represented to any network, mana-mana network pun, so this statement you can use. So dua statement kat sini, host and any, you can use inside ACE. You boleh pakai dalam statement. You pakai nantilah. Kita tengok. Nanti kita tengok contoh statement. Alright, so the 4.3 is about guideline for ACL creations. Macam mana kita nak buat dia punya guidelines. So specifically, a router interface can have one outbound. So we have one outbound IPv4 ACL, one inbound IPv4 ACL. Kita ada dua je, satu masuk, satu keluar lah, inbound and outbound. Same goes to IPv6. Okay, so guideline, the best practice for ACLs. So normally apa yang kita buat, kita akan menggunakan text editor lah. So the third statement ni penting. So normally kita best practice bila kita implement ACL, you will need to plan and write the statement. First, you write on notepad. For example, notepad or wordpad. Okay, you buat dalam text editor. Then, you implement, you will implement remarks command. Remarks will help us to identify later on. Bila kita buat show nanti, show access list for example, kita boleh ingat this statement untuk apa? ACL ni untuk apa? So we have the remark. So at least, for example, ACL 10 untuk you permitkan LAN satu LAN kepada internet. So kita tahu daripada perkataan remarks itself, we knows that what are the description for this entries for this ACL. Okay, so normally dua ni lah yang penting, text editor, remark. So remark is optional lah, bukannya wajib, tapi it will helps a lot of other people to know what statement is all about. Okay, so types of ACL yang ni saya dah bincang tadi, kita ada dua jenis, standard dan juga extended. So standard, either you permit or deny based on the source, melibatkan source address sahaja. Extended, permit or deny based on source, destination, ada empat, protocol and types of traffic, TCP or UDP port and more. So yang ni you all kena ingat. Okay, so we looks into the numbered ACL. So ACL ada dua, standard and extended. For standard ACL, we'll have two. Another two, which is numbered ACLs and named ACL. For extended, also have two types of ACL, which is numbered ACL and named ACL. So maksudnya ada empat lah kat sini. Standard ada dua, extended pun ada dua. Okay, so you can implement numbered and naming ACLs on standard and extended ACL. Kita tengok contoh eh, numbered ACL. So for standard ACL, number yang you can choose is 1 till 99 untuk standard. So kalau you nak pakai extended, nanti kita tengok lah. So untuk standard 1 till 99, or you can use 1300 till 1999. Okay, so yang ni kita banyak pakai lah. So normally kita pakai yang 1 till 99. Okay, name ACL. So preferred is the preferred name eh. So preferred method untuk kita configure standard ataupun extended menggunakan naming lah, name ACL. So naming extended ni is far better than having a number ACL 100, sebab kita boleh tengok perkataan itself naming. So at least, for example here, IP access list extended. So yang ni extended, tapi kat sini kita nampak lah nama tu. So nama ni kita boleh bagi macam description lah, FTP dash filter. So we doesn't need remarks anymore. Kita tak perlukan command remarks dah, sebab nama ni dah menunjukkan tujuan dia untuk kita buat filter, for example. Tapi kalau you letak lagi baguslah remarks untuk description. Okay, sebab tu implementations of naming ACLs is far better than ACL 100, sebab you tak tahu pun ACL 100 ni benda apa kalau you tak buat remarks. Alright, kalau you buat naming, from the name itself you dah tahu dah, oh ini adalah ACL untuk kita buat FTP filter, for example. Okay, so these are the command, for example. So for standard ACL, you need to use IP access list, okay, to create the kalau numbered ACL, so we go back. So kalau numbered ACL, dia hanya akan menggunakan access list eh. Kalau name ACLs, you can tambah IP ke depan, IP access list. Right, so for example, IP access list extended. So kalau you buat standard, standard lah. So this example shows the extended name access list. So give a name and then you put the command permit, types of traffic, either TCP, UDP or IP, source address, wildcard mask, destinations. Okay, so dekat belakang ni dia punya type of data, which is FTP. So nanti command kita akan tengok dalam part configurations. Okay, so next is about the interface, where we want to place the ACLs to that interface. So we know that we implement the ACLs on router. So kita buat command ni kat dalam router. So yang ni you all kena ingat lah. So dekat router yang mana kita nak buat? So these are the things that you need to know. So let's say we have router 1, router 2 and router 3 here. So the best practice for extended ACL. So kalau you pakai extended ACL, you kena letak dekat router yang close to the source as possible. Okay, yang paling dekat lah dengan source. Standard ACL should be located close to destination as possible. Sebab standard ACL hanya melibatkan source address. Okay, so you kena letak dekat network yang paling hampir dengan router tu. Contohnya katalah kita nak filter daripada sebelah 210, kita nak buat standard access list, kita katalah PC2 network ni belah sini sebelah 20 tak boleh pergi dekat this network. Ha, sini ke sini sebelah 10 ke 30 12 tak boleh. So dekat mana kita nak filter, takkan kita nak letak kat sini sebab dia hanya melibatkan source. So source mesti letak dekat router yang paling hampir. Kalau extended, router yang paling hampir dengan destination. Kalau kita nak buat kat sini kan, contoh bukan sini ya. Kalau sebelas dot zero network want to access to 30.12 network. Okay, daripada sini ke sini S2 network ke 2S3 network. For standard access list, you kena letak dekat router yang paling dekat dengan destination. Tadi tersilap kan? Okay, so for extended, yang paling hampir dengan source. Ha, you kena ingatlah, kalau standard destinations, extended dekat dengan source. Nanti kita akan tengok contoh. Okay, for example, in this figure, the administrator want to prevent traffic originate from this 10.0 network to 30.0 network. So 10.0 this network, network daripada 10.0 kita nak block ataupun nak deny for access to 30.0 dekat sini. Okay, maksudnya macam inilah. The network 10.0 nak block ke 30.0. So as we know that this is a standard, kita akan place dekat router yang close to the destination, which is R3 lah. So kita akan letak dekat R3. Persoalannya, R3 ada 3 interface. Serial, G0/0/0, G0/0/1. Ada 3 interface. So you nak apply the access list command dekat interface yang mana? Access list tadi. Alright. So dekat mana you nak place? So the question marks there lah. So kalau you letak dekat sini, inbound masuk dekat sini, what happened? Okay, 10.0 sampai ke sini, you block. Okay, let's say you block, you apply the access list on interface serial 0/1/1. Okay, as we know that this interface will carry multiple traffic, which is traffic from 10.0 network, 11.0 network, betul? Dia bawa dua network ni. Sampai kat sini, you block source. Okay, so bila you block source, betul dia akan block 10.0, tapi dia akan impact kepada dua-dua network sebab you block dekat sini. You block terus 10.0, so 10.0 tak akan keluar kepada S3 network and S4 network. So be careful when you want to apply the ACL on interface. You kena decide dekat mana. Betul-betul lah. So if you implement here, dia akan apply tempat yang betul. So kalau you apply dekat G001, 30.1 yang akan block. Okay, yang ni tak block. So kita akan apply on interface G0/0/0 outbound. Okay, keluar outgoing traffic, not incoming traffic, outbound eh. Okay, there are two possible interface. Yang ni saya cerita tadi, kita ada inbound and outbound. So kita dah bersekala tadi, right? So agak-agak boleh faham lah kot, insyaAllah. Extended ACL should be located close to the source as possible. So if you implement extended, kita letak dekat dengan source. For example, company A, company A kat sini, router 1, so router 3, sebab kita tak boleh nak ada access kepada semua router ni, router 3, router 2, we just have the access to router 1, so that's why we are going to implement close to our sources. Okay, so in this figure, for example, company A wants to deny telnet and FTP traffic to company B. Kalau kita tengok dekat sini, company A ni nak deny telnet dengan FTP. So, dua protokol. Deny telnet and FTP to company B. Okay, daripada mana? Daripada network 11.0. So, network ni lah. Network sini tak boleh pergi kepada company B 30.0. Tak boleh pergi ke sini. Tak boleh telnet and tak boleh FTP. Daripada S2 network to S3 network. Okay. So, kita nak letak dekat mana? So, satu, kita akan letak dekat close router. So, which is close source, which is router 1. So, kita akan implement dekat sini. So, now we need to identify which interface. Interface serial. G0/0/0 or G0/0/1. Interface mana yang kita nak apply. So, kalau you apply dekat sini, dia hanya akan impact 10.0. Kita nak block yang 11. So, kalau you apply dekat 11, okay, dikeluarkan. So, kalau you apply dekat sini, dikeluar tak? Okay. So, boleh juga dekat sini. Tetapi, beza antara serial dengan G interface. So, kalau you implement dekat G0/0/1, dia hanya filter the traffic from 11.0. Kalau you apply dekat sini, serial, dia akan filter sekali dengan yang ni, dengan yang sini. So, dia akan filter sekali 10.0 and 11.0, which is dua-dua traffic lah. Lagi banyak traffic yang dibuat filter. So, in terms of performance, slow sikit lah. Kalau you apply dekat G, dia hanya melibatkan 11.0. Okay. So, inbound, outbound. Right? So, dia akan melibatkan inbound lah. So, kat sini adalah yang terbaik. Alright? Okay, itu sahaja untuk this session. Right, thank you.